So this is my current situation at the moment. I got home from hospital last night, just sleeping and everything. With this at the moment, it's pretty tough. Got pretty bad headache most of the time. It's really hard to eat, and I've just been having smoothies and porridge and pumpkin soup all day. But yeah, you know, it comes with a job. Hard at the moment, but 6 to 8 weeks of hard work and hopefully I'll be back. But yeah, it's pretty swollen at the moment. I split my jaw here and shattered it over here. So they had to put a plate in on this side and a plate on this side. When I first done it on the field, I was looking for a tooth on the ground because I thought I'd lost a tooth because there was a big gap, but because my break was so bad, my jaw had moved a bit and separated and left a big gap in between my teeth. So I didn't lose any teeth, which was pretty good. Trying to do everything I can to get the swelling down. I feel bad for the kids and for Jess because, yeah, I'm not very helpful at the moment, which is pretty bad. Jude, my youngest, thinks I'm pulling a face at him all the time, so every time I look at him, he just starts laughing. Son.
Jude, look.
Son. He finds my face really funny. He thinks I'm pulling a face all the time.
Look, let's see.
Jude. You're a little fluffy. So it's breakfast time. This is my breakfast. It's porridge, a little bit of protein, some yogurt, a little bit of zinc. Yeah, I never eat porridge, so it's pretty sloppy, and hopefully it stops me from losing so much weight. It is day 6 post surgery. My face isn't too swollen, it's gone down a bit. Just after Harvey Norman to get a ninja bullet, just so I can make smoothies and take them with me. Smoothies are going to be my best friend over the next 5 weeks. It hasn't been too rough of a week. Still able to do most things. What are you smiling for?
No, it's been fun.
I went into the club today to see everyone. The boys are training, so I didn't get to see any of the boys, but I've seen some of the staff and got to weigh myself, and I've lost 5 kilos already, so I need to start eating a bit more and a bit more frequently. First week, it's been alright.
Yeah.
Yeah. Second week starts now. Just about to make my morning smoothie. I'll show you what goes in it. My morning smoothie done. Pretty thick. Probably could have done with a bit more coconut water, but yeah, that'll do. It's Friday today, a week since surgery. I'm going to see the doctor today, hopefully get the stitches out in the side of my face. Swelling seems to be going down a little bit. Not too sore. Last night slept pretty well. Whenever I get injured, you know, I get to spend more time with my family. Obviously I want to be playing, but you gotta look at the bright side of everything, and I'm trying to do that with my jaw. I get 8 weeks at home with my family, me going nowhere, so positive in that. I think the hardest thing about the first week so far has definitely been the sleeping and the eating part. I haven't struggled too much with the pain. I think this part of my face is still numb, so I can't feel from about here this way and then Yeah, there's like a big, there's like a circle here I can't feel. So I think the numbness is kind of helping me a bit with the pain. The swelling's going down, but yeah, the hardest bit definitely been eating and sleeping. Sleeping's getting better. Hopefully the eating gets better. It's only week one. I've got to eat like this for 6 weeks, which is going to be the toughest part. I'm going to be over smoothies and that by about the 3 week mark, I reckon. Keep the variety up in my dinners so I don't get sick of them either. You know, I found that I loved spaghetti bolognese. It tasted pretty yum, but everything gets boring quick if you're having it every night. Another thing that I've struggled with over the first week is just doing things that I normally do with the kids. Obviously, you know, I'm a hands-on dad, and you know, kids have seen a different side of me this week. I'm not as bubbly and as weird as I usually am at home. So just finished up at the doctor's, got my stitches out on my cheek. Some good news, he's pretty sure that I'll be back in 6 weeks, so I'm bloody excited about that. Six is the target, six is the goal. I'm going to do everything in my power to make sure that my body's right. You know, my goal starting out was always to play 100 games, whether it would be in rugby union, whether it would be in rugby league. I think I'm around 80 at the moment, and this injury has kind of set me back a bit. I was looking at playing my 100th game midway throughout the year, but now it's going to be towards the end of the year, so hopefully, if all goes well, make it back in the team. I'll be playing my 100th game this year, and it's going to be a bloody emotional one. I've had 9 surgeries and I'm 27. You think that a 27-year-old should have played 100 games easy, but with my injury past and what I've been through, 100 games for me is a realistic target, and I'll be bloody proud of myself. You know, the average career of an NRL player is only like 20 to 30 games or something like that, something crazy, crazy low. But to play 100 is going to be really special, and yeah, it just goes to show, you know, no matter what setbacks you get, no matter how many times you get knocked down, you can always achieve something. Hey, darling, where are we?
Are we in the crate?
Yeah, we are. So we're just dropping Della at crèche. It's my first day back at training today, so I'm pretty excited to get back into the swing of things. My jaw's gone down a lot. If you didn't know me, it'd look normal. But yeah, still a little bit swollen, but nothing too bad. Still can't eat. I made a good meal last night. I made some lamb shanks with some pea mash, which was awesome. You gonna have fun at crèche today, darling?
Yeah.
Yeah? What are you gonna do at crèche?
Sand.
You're gonna play in the sand pit.
Yeah.
That's cool. Daddy's gonna miss you at crèche.
Yeah.
Alright, I'll see you later, okay?
Yeah. Let's hop out.
Yeah, let's hop out. Yeah, so I just dropped Dale off at crèche. I'm on my way to training now. First week back at training, so it's a bit exciting. So got diamonds by the polo, come with the Tony Momo for clowns and all the balls. So AP going psycho, lil' mama bad like Michael. Can't really trust nobody with all this jewelry on you. My roof look like a no-show, got diamonds by the polo. Don't act like you my friend when I'm rolling through my hands. Oh, you stuck in the friend zone. I time like 4, 5, or 5. Ayy, 100 bins inside my short Chino, the shit. Try to stuff it all in, but it don't even fit. Ayy, know that I've been with the shits ever since the jit. Ayy, I made my first million, I'm like, shit, this is it. Ayy, 34, a walk through, man, we had every slit. Ayy, had so many bottles, gave ugly girl a sip. Out the window, what a bitch. Day one, let's get it. All the boys will probably be in their meetings right now. So
hopefully I can float in and sneak in some physio before they get down and prepare for training. But they want it. Day one of the comeback, of the jaw comeback. There's been plenty of comebacks. That's why I'm good, so good at these things, and that's why I stay positive about it, because you know I've been through it so many times, and it's doable. Time and time again. There's no reason to give up. No reason to give up. Especially when you work for a company like the Broncos and you play with a group of the teammates that you play with. There's no reason to give up. But without y'all, I couldn't kick it like this. I wanna thank you for making me who I am.